Ingelesa jaunta jabe da Eskoziako jendartean. Baina badira berezko bi hizkuntza, eskoziera, germaniar jatorria duena, eta gaelikoa, zelta. Azken honetan aditua da Rob Dunbar, Edimburgoko Unibertsitateko irakaslea. Kanadako Eskozia berrian jaio zen, ara emigratutako eskoziar familia baten ondorengo gisa.
Gaelic is spoken by almost 60,000 people in Scotland. It has declined over the years, but the decline has not been so sharp between 2001 and 2011. The situation of Gaelic in terms of infrastructure has improved quite considerably. Before 1985, there was no Gaelic medium education, but since 1985, Gaelic medium education has increased to the point where we have now children in Gaelic medium education in about 60 schools in Scotland, and almost 3,000 students are learning Gaelic as the medium of instruction. In other areas of development, television has been, and media has been very important. We now have a Gaelic radio service that broadcasts every day of the week. We also have a Gaelic television service now offered by the BBC, BBC Alapa. So the situation in the media has much improved. Recent research by colleagues here at the University of Edinburgh on Scottish social attitudes have shown, again, a rather ambiguous picture. The majority of the respondents, and it's a representative sample of people in Scotland, a majority think and recognise that Scotland is a part of Scottish identity, Gaelic is a part of Scottish identity, is an important part of Scottish identity, but at the same, by the same token, a majority also said that it's not important for them to have the language. It's important that Scotland has it, but it's not necessary for somebody to be a full Scot and speak Gaelic. So the country values it, but a majority of people don't value it enough to feel that they need or even want to learn it. They can be just as Scottish without the language.
Gaelikoak eskoziarren partetik pairatzen duen jarrera hori egunerokotasunean nabari da. Baita azken hilabeteetan herrialdean bizi den erreferendum kanpainan ere.
Promises that have been made and discussion about Gaelic and indeed about Scots, the other indigenous language of Scotland, there's been very little coming from both sides. The campaigns themselves have been disappointing in that both sides have used very little Gaelic in their publicity materials and in their in dealing with the public. And that's been true of most, although not all, but most of the independent activist organizations. The debate has largely been through the medium of English, which has to be a disappointment to both Gaelic and Scots language activists. Language activists campaigned for a bilingual Gaelic-English ballot paper for the referendum. The Scottish government opposed a bilingual paper, and therefore the papers will be in English only. Then I go backwards and forwards between being rather pessimistic and then optimistic about the language. I'll start with the reasons for being pessimistic. I think the main one is the ongoing decline in the numbers of speakers, but on the optimistic side, however, the much more institutional support that than there's ever been. There's a Gaelic medium education, which in spite of its problems, continues to grow. We have much greater Gaelic media and Gaelic television. There's a lot of activity now in the cultural sphere, particularly Gaelic writing. So we have a very lively and engaged literary scene. In some respects, the constitutional change that would come with independence would create opportunities to extend the impact of the Gaelic Language Act in 2005. I'd like to be hopeful. I'd like to be hopeful, and I'd like to hope that in the future Gaelic can prosper and that it can continue to be spoken as a community language.